Eliezer, one of the most righteous Gentiles in the history of the world. I want to remind you, there are 10 people who went to heaven with their bodies. They were not buried. There's a list of them. One of them is Eliezer, in case you were wondering how righteous he is or not. He comes from a cursed nation named nation of Canaan. Noah cursed his grandson Canaan, the son of Ham. So the nation is cursed forever. They cannot remove the curse of Noah. But it doesn't mean that a cursed goy cannot be righteous. As long as he has a curse on him because he comes from that race that is cursed. But being righteous is a matter of will. You want to be righteous or not? You working hard to be righteous or not? No one is forcing you to be wicked or to be righteous. It's 100% in your hand, like the Rambam writes in Ilchot Tshuva. Now let's see what Avraham said to his servant. Go and find a wife to my son, Yitzchak. But how are you going to find a wife? I want to warn you in advance. Let's see. Vayomer elav, Avraham said to Eliezer, I want you to go and find a wife to my son. Put your hands under my thigh and swear in the name of God, the God of heaven and earth, that you will not take a wife to my son from the nation of Canaan, meaning your nation. Eliezer is Canaani. He's from Canaan. He said to him, make sure you do not bring my son any girl from your nation. Do not bring. Even though we sit and live among them, I want you to go to my original place of birth and you bring a wife to my son Yitzchak from there. So, Rabotai, why Avraham is sending Eliezer so far to find a wife? What's the problem? What, in the whole land of Canaan, you cannot find one good girl? Not that in the other place there is any righteous girls. Zenevela zetrefa. In the end, who did he get? Rivka comes from the worst house. Her father is a murderer, Betuel, and her brother is the biggest crook on earth, ever. He took advantage on Yaakov for 20 years. Idol worshiper crook. So what kind of a bargain he found? Rivka herself is extremely holy and righteous. But what house she grew up in? The worst house. Same thing Avraham. What house did he grow in? His father was an idol worshiper selling idols to the public. Avraham didn't born in Bnei Brak or in Mea Shearim or in Lakewood. Where did he grow up? Avraham, in a house of Bernie Sanders. Father, Baruch Hashem, Terach at least made tshuva in the end of his life. For the honor of Avraham, such a legendary holy tzaddik, and his father will go to hell. I don't want to upset my son Abraham. I have to help to make sure his father will repent. So his father repented. And what was his end? He died. And what happened to his father, Terach? He had to come back again in reincarnation to pay for all his idol-worshipping sins, even though he repented. He left it. He dumped the idols. He asked for forgiveness. What we call tshuva. It wasn't enough. Machti harabim, en maspikim biyado lasot tshuva. If you influence the public to do wicked things, to become wicked, to act wicked, to behave wicked. As much as you repent, it's very hard to overcome the negative you left in the world. Because how many good things you can do as an individual? You do one good thing and at the same time all your students continue with their idol worshipping. You're going in reverse. Hashem sent him back in reincarnation. Who was he in his next life? Iyov. Job, the book of Job, that's Terach. How much he suffered, all his children died, all his money went, sicknesses, all his friends turned their back on him. terrible. All of that for the past life. And he was very righteous in the next life. Yov, messenger of God. He wasn't a Jew, by the way. Terach died as a goy. And Yov also was born as a goy. Avraham became an Hebrew, meaning he came out of his goyish lifestyle and became the first Hebrew. And after that, later on, Judaism started in Mount Sinai. So let's see, Rabotai. He's warning him, do not get a woman from the land of Canaan. Go to the place of my birth, and from there find a girl with kindness, with good traits, good personality. These Canaanim do not have good traits. Their mentality is not good. Make sure don't find a girl over there. Top. Then we continue. You know, why does he have to say this language? It says, "Velakachta isha libni leitzchak." Lebni leitzchak. It's like two individuals here. And you took a wife to my son, to Yitzchak. No, you should have said, and you should get a wife to my son, Yitzchak. That's the proper language. You don't have to say two twice. To my son, to Yitzchak. It's like two sons. Do you get the point or no? This is a divine language here. There's no place for errors. Why did Hashem use this language, meaning Avraham used this language? Find a wife to my son. To my son. So there's one, two. To Yitzchak. Find a wife to my son Yitzchak, or to my son, that's it. We know who we're talking about. I have only one son. The answer is, it's not enough you find a wife to my son. That's the general order, the mission, to find shidduch to my son. No. But there is another mission. The wife that you're going to find have to be the right, exactly the right wife for my son, Yitzchak. Yitzchak is not like me. I am the symbol of chesed. Avraham is the symbol of kindness. Yaakov is the symbol of emet, Torah. Yoshev, Ishtam Yoshev Oalim. Yitzchak is judgment, strict judgment. That's the truth and that's it. No mercy. Strict judgment. To live with a person that is only strict judgment, midat adin, it's not easy. You need a wife to balance his judgment traits. It's very judgmental. To be judgmental is a positive thing or a negative thing? The answer, it's a very positive thing. You must be judgmental. If someone is risky and look fishy, you have to be extra careful. If you have a gun, get ready. He may turn around and attack you any minute. Why? Because this kind of person usually attacks. The way he dresses, the way he looks, or the area where I am. It's a dangerous place. Record shows a lot of people got mugged there. Especially middle of the night. Why are you so judgmental? Because you have to be judgmental. Otherwise, you'll be dead. Don't be a fool. If someone bang on your door at 3 a.m., you have to assume it's some Nazi anti-Semite who came to kill you. Try to break the wall. Don't be judgmental. Maybe the poor person is about to die from hunger. Maybe. But there's a much higher chance someone came to kill me. Or there could be a tragedy also. Someone needs a ride to the hospital. I don't know. Something happened by the neighbor. It could be many things. I have to go down with my gun. Why you brought the gun? I'm your neighbor. Why? Because I have to be alert. Bottom line, you must be judgmental. But you cannot be only judgmental. Only judgment is not good. Only mercy is not good. There has to be a balance. You have to know when to be in judgment, and when to be in mercy. Only mercy, it's a disaster. Only judgment, it's a disaster. A combination is wonderful. Avraham knows that Yitzchak, his midat hadin is strict. He must have a wife that will balance him, will ease him. Don't rush. Breathe. Calm down, my dear husband. Yes, you're 100% right. That's the law. That's what needs to be done. But let's mix a little bit mercy. You know? Find a wife to my son. That's the general rule. But now I'm giving you a more specific rule. Which wife? A wife that will match someone that is midat adin. Okay?